We're on a mission to facelift our Mercedes, and Mike has managed to source the main bit to do it. This is a current model grille. It's much more contemporary than the 19-year-old model we've currently got attached to our car, and it should bolt straight on. I'm going to get it painted that lovely metallic grey that the rest of the car is, and while I'm at that, I thought I might as well do these front headlight surrounds because they were looking a bit tired, but also the original rear bumper. Now you can see they've all been primed ready for the top coat. I've got one more addition just here, which is our replacement front bumper, because the original one was a bit too mangled to fix. Now the idea is to paint them all exactly the same grey to get that lovely colour-coded look that should really freshen up our Mercedes. Well, it's all ready, I best get out their way.
Mr. B has spent £299 on the new front grille. For once, he's decided to go for an aftermarket part because it's about £100 cheaper.
Errol's just putting on a special coat of plastic primer onto our front grille because it's never been painted before. And we need a special layer of adhesive material to go between the top coat and the plastic beneath.
The car looks black in some lights, but the actual colour is a kind of graphite grey. It's got a lovely metallic quality which gives the car real class.
Now in the old days, metallic paint used to cost about 50% more because of the lacquer, but nowadays they actually put lacquer on solid colour as well, so really it's only just marginally more expensive.
Together this paintwork will probably cost around £500, but it's going to be the bling that hopefully lands us a punter, as Mike would say.
Well, Errol's doing well, but I'm going to leave him to it because I've got loads more updating work to do on our G-Wagon back at the workshop.